हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू? आई थिंक यू मस्ट हैव बीन फिट एंड फाइन, एंड दिस इज फॉरवेश चौधरी। अगेन आई वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू वंस अगेन ऑन दिस लर्निंग प्लेटफॉर्म। एंड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई हम्बली रिक्वेस्ट टू ऑल ऑफ यू दैट प्लीज सब्सक्राइब द चैनल। इफ यू डिड सब्सक्राइब यट देन प्लीज सब्सक्राइब फर्स्ट एंड गिव योर प्रेसेस लाइक्स, कमेंट्स एंड शेयर एज वेल। थैंक यू। सो फ्रेंड्स, एज यू कैन सी ऑन द स्क्रीन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द कंपनी एंड द Crown rule in India. All right, let's move on the topic. Here is the first slide on your computer screen. Here you can see, and as you can see on the screen, the Montague Chelmsford Reformed Government of India Act 1919. Okay, and let's see what happens as per this act. And as you can see in the very first line, act introduced the dyarchy for instance. Rule of two, which means executive councillors and popular ministers, government was to be the head of provincial administration. What it means, friends, here the India first time the English person introduced the dyarchy system. For example, you can say that they introduced the lower house and upper house system. Okay, they brought some constitutional reforms, right, in the form of dyarchy system, right? And as per this, executive councillor and popular ministers, they took part, okay? And government was to be the head. Ultimately, the government, central government, was the head of the provincial administration, right? In the second line, as you can see, subject was segregated into two parts, reserve list and transferred list. What does it mean, friend? You can see here the reserve list and transfer list. Actually, reserve list means the sector which had high importance, they took over them. You can say they grabbed under the central governance. Like for example, you can take like defense sector, foreign sector, foreign affairs, and economic affairs, and communication sector, and civil laws. Fine. And in transfer list, you can, for example, you can take it like agriculture sector, and health sector, education sector. Okay. And apart from this, some other sectors you can, for instance. So they are the they were in the transfer list. Fine. And let's move on the third line here. Legislature. It was expanded. 70% of the members were to be elected, and the system of class electorates as well as communal class was consolidated. Consolidated means sort of making strong, right? What they intensely wanted, actually, they behind the curtain, behind this constitutional reforms, the ultimate aim, right, the main intent was to introduce the was to form was to consolidate the communal system, communal class system. And apart from this, they announced that 70% of the members were to be elected. Fine. And the major, you can say, the major right or major achievement which taken place at that point of time, the women were given voting rights, right, as you can see in the screen, on the screen. So here, this is the it was the Montague Chelmsford Reform Government of India Act. You can say also it was called Government of India Act 1919. It was introduced in 1919. So keep remember, right? So you can recall it later, students. So let's move on the next act. Here you can see on the Government of India Act, which was introduced in 1935. And let's see what happens as per this act. And first of all, here additionally, I would like to some points here. You know, friends, you might have been thinking that what exactly lower house and upper house? The lower house means there were 145 members, and the tenure was 3 years, right? And in these 145 members, 41 members was nominated by the British government, and 26 member official, and 15 non-official. 15 member were non-official, and 26 official, right? And there was, you can say, in the elected 104, right? 104 elected, and 52 in which elected 104, 52 general, 30 Muslims, 26 and 20 special, fine. And in the case of upper house, there were totally 60 members and the tenure was 5 years, right? And in which 60 members, 26 were nominated by the British government and 34 were elected, fine. In the elected members, 20 from general, 10 from Muslims and 3 Europeans, right? And 1 Sikh, okay. So I hope you must have understood, right? This bicameral legislature system, the lower house and upper house system, which was introduced in the in the Chelmsford reformed, as you can Montague Chelmsford reformed Government of India Act in 1919. Let's see on the next slide here, the Government of India Act 1935, right? Let's see what happens as per this act here, friends. As you can see on the screen in very first line, here the act ended the system. What happens here? This act ended the diarchy system, right? And ultimately the power goes went to Federation of India, right? Was established for both British India and some or all of the princely states, right? Actually it was established for both British India and some or all of the princely states. Let's see in the next line here, in the second line here, you can see over here the introduction of direct elections, thus increasing the franchise from 7 billion to 35 million people, right? A partial reorganization of the provinces, Sindh was separated from Bombay. You know what happens, what is happening over here, friends, that the first time they introduced the direct elections, in which they increased the number of 7 million to 35 million, and they given voting rights. Franchise means voting rights, right, to the people, to the common people, to all the people, right? And a partial reorganization of the provinces. You know what? They given some identification, reorganizations of the provinces, and Sindh was separated from Bombay. What it means? What does it mean here? That Sindh was separated from the Bombay Presidency. Earlier it was under the Bombay Presidency. So I hope you must have understood, students. And this is the third point here. Bihar and Orissa were split into separate provinces of Bihar and Orissa. Earlier what has been happening over here, that Bihar and Orissa were under the Bengal Presidency, but after taking shape, after introducing these bills, these reforms, Bihar and Orissa were split into a separate provinces. Okay, I hope you must have understood. And Burma was completely separated from India. Okay, so as per this act, the Burma was the part of India earlier, but it was separated, right, by the Government of India Act 1935. Aden was also detached from India and established as a separate colony. This question is very important. Sometimes may be asked, right? You can save it. Aden is not in Indian territory, right? Is not a part of India. Actually, it was located in the south of the Yemen and it was under the British Empire, right? So after existing this Government of India Act, Aden was also detached from India and established as a separate colony, fine. And let's move on the next line here. The membership of the provincial assemblies was altered so as to include more elected Indian representatives, right? What has been happening again here on the ground, right? So the membership of the provincial assemblies was altered, was modified. Why they modified it? Because the ultimate aim was to include more elected Indian representatives, right? Actually, the Indian representative were protesting and they were making the demands, right? They should be in the government, right? They want representation in the government, basically, right? So it was the basic objective of this points, right? Here let's move again forward. The who were now able to form majorities and be appointed to form governments. Actually further rights were given to them, that they were now able to form majorities, right, and be appointed to form governments, and they were further appointed to form governments, right? I hope you must have understood, friends. And the last point of this Government of India Act, which was introduced in 1935 here, the establishment of federal court. Actually, the first of all, it came into existence. The establishment of a federal court was established in India, and the sitting place and the sitting chamber of this federal court was inside the parliament building, which is located in the India. So it was the changes. They were the points which was made by the British administration. I hope you must have really enjoyed this little lecture, and I sincerely appeal to all of you guys that please, if you really liking supporting these videos, if you really like the videos, then please give your precious supports. Actually, your support, your love, and your compliments always value us, right? And always motivate us. So please keep watching and keep supporting. Meet again in the next video. Till then, thank you. Bye.